In this video, we will walk through viewing and assigning your auxiliary switch inputs to functions related to your configuration. This will apply to both planting and application configuration types. It is important to know how these are assigned and how they can be changed so as an operator, you know what sections, rows, or nozzles are tied to which switch on your switch box or built-in switches in your applicator. Sometimes we need to assign multiple sections, rows, or nozzles to one switch as there are less switches than there are of those functions. These switch assignments are only for manual control. AutoSwath will still control them independently as determined by your configuration. For this video, we will view and adjust the switch assignments for a John Deere 4920 equipped with Direct Command L2 and Right Spot that we have already built the configuration for. Starting on the home screen of the In Command display, tap the Setup app. Select the configuration you'd like to view or edit the switches for, then tap the wrench in the middle. On the left, tap Auxiliary Input to enter the Auxiliary Input Assignments screen. The table will show your switch inputs on the left side and will show the functions, which in this case are nozzles, that are assigned to that switch input on the right. By default, on a right spot configuration, it will divide them as evenly as possible and then put the remaining nozzles on the last switch. For this example configuration, we are going to divide them equally to have 7 nozzles assigned to each switch, except number 5 and 6, where we'll have 8 nozzles assigned. Tap the Assign button in the upper right to adjust the assignments. On the top half, we have our available switch inputs, and the bottom, we have the functions of our configuration, in this case, each nozzle. Tapping a switch on the top will highlight it green. If there is no yellow X on the switch, that indicates there is a function or functions assigned to that switch. For a full glossary of the icons in this screen, tap the Help button in the bottom left. The functions assigned to the selected switch will highlight green down below. We will tap to add an 8th nozzle to switch number 5. By doing this, it automatically unassigned it from switch 6 and moved it to switch 5. Functions can only be assigned to one switch at a time. We'll then tap switch 6 and tap nozzle 43 and 44 for 8 total. We will repeat the process for switches 7 through 10 to ensure they then have 7 nozzles each. Once you have the switches assigned how you would like, tap the green check. You can then see your updated switch assignments in the table. If you have a remote master switch or a foot pedal attached to your switch box, you'll need to change the master source dropdown to the appropriate external source. Switch assignments can always be reset back to the default by tapping the Reset All button in the bottom right. Tap the back arrow to return to the configuration setup screen. Now you will be able to view and edit your auxiliary input switch assignments for your planting or application configuration on your in-command display. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.